American vodka. On this American Independence Day weekend, make sure your cocktails are top rung by using an American vodka. So grab an American Mule with Wheatley American Vodka. And you can take that to the bank. But we are in Madison Square Garden tonight, New York City, and Wade, we kick things off with a bang.
Yeah, the Bloodline were coming to the ring at the start of the show. We never got to find out why, because their victims from last week, Randy Orton, Kevin Owens, and the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes, cut them off before business could be taken care of with a little vengeance. This is the Viper doing what he does best, wrecking bodies everywhere he goes. KO, of course, putting his body on the line, leaving a trail of destruction behind him. The bedlam went all over the arena that was, until thankfully, at long last, the NYPD showed up, taking these three out of the arena. As GM Nick Aldis looked on, I can confirm all three were sent packing from Madison Square Garden. They have gone.
Accompanied by WWE Hall of Famer, the Wise Man, Paul Heyman, representing the Bloodline, Tamatanga, Tungaloa, and Solo Sikoa.
It is time for the Bloodline acknowledgement ceremony, led to the ring by the new head of the table, Solo Sikoa. Flanking Solo, on the left of your screen, the right-hand man, Tama Tonga. On the right, the infamous Tongaloa. And in the rear, the Wise Man, the WWE Hall of Famer, Paul Heyman. And Wade, we've been assured by Solo that Jacob Fatu is not in the building tonight. But that does not make the feeling and the atmosphere any easier going.
I don't think there's anything that makes me easy around Solo Sikoa. However, the last thing he did say to Paul Heyman was that he is listening to the Wise Man, and that feels like the first time in months there has been some complete harmony within the Bloodline. Perhaps Paul Heyman finally can breathe a little easier.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Paul Heyman. Tonight, live in the world's most famous
Before we get to that, Paul, let me introduce to you the newest member of the Bloodline, the Samoan Werewolf, my enforcer, Jacob Fatu.
Wade at the beginning of the evening. Solo assured Paul Heyman that Jacob Fatu was not in the garden. That obviously was not the truth. But this man is an absolute menace, Wade.
Everything Solo said earlier can be completely disregarded because the most volatile, lawless individual in the history of this industry is here at Madison Square Garden.
This is a man who, athletically speaking, has all the gifts of the entire bloodline. But as far as morality goes, this man knows no such thing. The Samoan Werewolf has arrived for the Bloodline Acknowledgement Ceremony. Yeah!